I don't know who Wizards and Word Slingers is, but apparently they did a video using Stephen King's method for D&D. I've been using his method forever. And anyway, you know, for roleplay and stuff. I'm curious what this guy says and if we match.
Stephen King is one of the most well-known and prolific writers of the last 100 years. Also, one of my favorites. He's been the inspiration for many of my own novels, and his tips have helped millions to write their own stories. But I think his writing advice can slide right into the DMs of game mastering advice with only a little bit of adjustment. A couple decades ago, King published a memoir/writing advice book named On Writing, and we're going to mine it for stuff to help you improve running your games. Let's dig in. Number 1. First, write for you, and then worry about others. When you write a story, you're telling yourself the story. When you rewrite, your main job is to take out the things that are not the story. I think...
Okay, so far, we don't agree. I'm not writing a story. I'm not writing a story. I'm role-playing. So this guy's a frustrated writer, it sounds like. He wants to write a story for his players.
I think we all know that the GM's primary job is to provide a playground where your players can run around, skin their knees, and start fights with the other children. But you, GM, have to remember that you are also a player at the table.
Okay, let's say you want to write a story about kids at a playground fighting the bully or fighting each other, whatever. Why would you do that? What about this? You make interesting characters that are character-driven. Those characters will make their own, will do their own thing. Instead of forcing your characters to do a scene that you think would be nice to write about. Kids fighting in a playground.
You should be creating NPCs that are fun to play. You should be making worlds that you enjoy. You should be creating toys that are fun to watch.
How about you make the characters interesting? They're character driven. The characters will make the world. The characters, maybe the goal may be to change their surroundings around them. You know, maybe the characters aren't happy with their lifestyle. Their living conditions. They want to change those things. In a way, they're changing the world. They're world building. It seems backwards to me. If you're building a world and then you populate it with fun NPCs that are fun to play, that just seems ludicrous to me.
Others play with. When King says write for yourself, I don't view that in a selfish light at all. If you are running a campaign for a tabletop RPG and you are not enjoying yourself, then it's going to come out at the table. Sure, sometimes the story...
Why would you not be enjoying... Okay, D&D is... Everyone says D&D is fun. If you're not enjoying the game, what's going on? I mean, I know what's going on. I know what's going on if you're not enjoying the game. So why are you doing it? Why are you... It's a bit late, isn't it? If you're playing a game and it's not fun, I think that's a bit late. How did you get there? You ended up with an ugly house and an ugly wife, and you ask yourself, how did you get there?
The story veers into directions you might not have chosen, but if you learn to find the fun in the chaos, then you'll always be pleasantly surprised when things change course.
Okay, so he doesn't know what he's talking about then. He didn't learn anything from Stephen King.
2. Don't use passive voice. Timid writers like passive verbs for the same reason that timid lovers like passive partners. The passive voice is safe. This might seem like technical advice, but I think we can find the lesson here in being active. Sometimes players will foof and faff and plod and spend time doing nothing at all. And a little bit of that is fine, but we don't want the pace to lag for too long. Sometimes you need to create the conflict. Don't be afraid.
Okay, what about the players that just sit there for an hour and don't say a word during the game? Because you're talking for the players? You're role-playing for the player characters. You're role-playing all the characters in the game. So the players, all they can do really is wait for you to say, roll dice. That's how most games are run, right? I was watching, what's the guy's name? Jim Grimm? He was running a game yesterday. For 2 hours, he was talking about the player characters and what the player characters were doing and saying. He was role-playing the fucking player characters. You know, I have this thing where if the GM's able to fudge dice, the players should be able to fudge dice. If the GM's role-playing the PCs, well, the players should be able to role-play the NPCs. Makes sense, right? Man, people are doing this shit-ass backwards.
Afraid to have an ogre kick down the door. Don't be afraid to have that treasured NPC suddenly betray the party to spice things up. Players love to be surprised, and sometimes you gotta take big swings to make that happen. In campaign 1 of Wizards and Wordslingers, I already know this game sucks.
Do I need to go on his channel and... I already know this. I've seen him before. Oh my god. Okay. You guys are not role players. Why do you even have a channel?
I had fire giants destroy the city of Baldur's Gate. I needed something huge and catastrophic to happen, and that fit the bill nicely. Don't be scared to shake things up and make sweeping changes to the realm or its denizens.
Okay, you suck. I'm not watching the rest of this.